Fatboy Slim is no stranger to playing on the beach, and he's going to be here at the Zero Gravity Beach Festival, April the 27th, and he's on the phone with us right now. Good morning, sir. How are you?
Good morning. I'm very well. How are you doing?
We're doing really well, thank you. Now, first of all, do I call you Fatboy? Is it Mr. Slim? I mean, I'm from East Sussex. Do I call you Norm?
Well, my friends call me Norm, yeah.
Okay, I'll take that as Norm.
Yes.
Right, I guess the most important thing for us right now is that you are coming back to the UAE, and we're all very, very excited. You clearly like it here. You keep coming back. What do you love about playing here so much?
Dubai is a very interesting place to visit anytime. But there's something about the crowd and the vibe. I think there's something about the fact that doing something, especially like Zero Gravity, is such an occasion that people who don't go out very much tend to save up and go out. And they're my favourite crowds, the ones that haven't been out for a while and they're really letting their hair down.
And that's exactly what's happening. I mean, the hype around the Zero Gravity Beach Festival is getting there already. Everyone's very excited. So aside from that, April the 27th, is there anything on your tourist list that you want to tick off? Because you've been here so many times. You must have done a few of the classics,
yeah.
But...
yeah, you know what? I think I've done every single one of the kind of classic tourist things and then some of the foodie tourist things. Yeah, I'm going to have to start getting more obscure. So I'm open to suggestions of sure things that don't involve indoor ski slopes or the Burj Khalifa or, you know the off the beaten track tourist things for me.
Well, that's the thing. Yeah, I mean, as you know, everything. I mean, when was the last time you were here? Probably the last things. I mean, we've had a few theme parks open, water parks, even safari parks. Or do I see you as more of an arts man? We've got the Louvre Abu Dhabi now. We've got an opera house.
Oh, definitely more the arts than theme park, yes. Actually, last time I went, there was a really good street art exhibition on.
Oh, nice.
I'm trying to... and you know that really long street that people walk down?
I want to say...
there's many long streets there, but not.
I want to say JBR on the beach, was it? Jumeirah Beach Walk?
That's the JBR. Last time I was here, there was an art trail, a street art on JBR. That's the kind of cultural things. I do love my street art, and I'm quite aware that there's quite a lot going on in Dubai, so that'll probably be what I'm searching out this time.
Okay, well, I'm happy to give you some top tips. Are you here for a while, or are you straight in, straight out?
Nah, straight in, straight out, but I'm around for a day, I think. I think we don't fly until the evening after the show, so I've got time to have a bit of a mooch.
Nice, all right.
You know? Treat for me. Normally it's completely straight in and out, but it being Dubai and it being a pleasant place to hang out, we're going to spend a bit of time.
Okay, perfect. All right, well, I'll send you my top tips. Now you've got a ridiculously long CV, but I understand you can now add music director to that as well. Tell us more.
Yeah, I'm working with a director called Julian Temple on a film, and I am, musical. I think I said musical director, musical consultant. I'm not quite sure. I've never done this before, so I don't know what my actual title is. I'm not doing the whole soundtrack. I'm doing some music, but I'm sort of curating. Basically, it's Ibiza the silent movie, which requires quite a lot of music to tell the story because we haven't got talking heads to do it for us.
Yeah, exactly. And obviously with Julian Temple's, you know, again, his long list as well. And the Glastonbury documentary film he did was just incredible. So we can expect big things.
I expect the unexpected with Julian every time. It's not just what you would think Ibiza is. It's basically telling the story of Ibiza from the Phoenicians and the Romans, but working out from how we got to Ibiza present day from the historical angle, which is really interesting and quite startling.
Yeah, it's going to be very, very different.
Starting from where, did you know where the name Ibiza came from?
No, do tell.
It came from Ibiza, which means the island of Bez, who is the Phoenician god of dance, can you believe? So it's named after a Phoenician god of dance called Bez.
No way!
Yeah, but it's spelled B-E-S, not B-E-Z.
Okay, I was going to say, no comparison there.
Well, there might be a comparison. Bez might be in the film. You never know. But it's that kind of curveball rather than just like, oh, you know, here we go, like the lads in the West End.
Yeah, exactly. No, I can't wait to see it. Now, I understand that you were looking for people to star in the film and they could upload their video. I need to know, have I missed the boat there or have I still got a chance?
No. If you've got some really interesting, yeah. I mean, obviously, the Julian style of making is very much a collage of different, different like old film, brand new film. So he's shot a load of stuff last summer on the island. But also, we're just looking for people's memories over the years of what they've got up to in Ibiza, which Julian can kind of insert into the historical bit in his own inimitable style.
Amazing. I mean, I'm not sure whether the word memories in Ibiza, I mean, is there a lot of memory that happens in Ibiza?
Well, that's the thing. If you recorded it on camera or on your camera phone, then that might jog your memory of what you actually got up to.
Yeah, exactly. All right, listen, I'm going to do a quick fame test with you, if you don't mind. This is something, it's a quick fire question round, and we do it with all of the people that we interview. And we had a lot of fun with this in Tomorrowland in Belgium. So it's only six questions. Are you okay, ready, Mr. Slim?
I think so.
All right, here we go.
Let's find out, shall we?
Yeah, exactly. Let's find out. So, first of all, do you still do your own social media?
Can I pass on these questions?
Definitely not. It's a yes or a no.
Can I answer a question with a question?
You may.
Did I ever do my own social media?
Oh, you are ultimate superstar. Okay.
No, I did not. Or ultimate Luddite, who doesn't really understand.
True. Okay. All right. But I'm afraid you still get
I do still have a very direct input into my social media.
Okay.
Should we put it that way?
Do you know what? I'm going to give you half a point, half point.
I feed the beast, but I don't actually know how to technically get things onto social media, so yeah, I have help.
Okay, you're honest.
But if you see my Instagram and Twitter, you know it's me, because you think that I've filmed and you know it is me.
But I don't
physically actually know. I don't actually know how to get something that I've taken onto social media.
Okay, fair enough. This is going to be brilliant. We're going to have a little session when you come to Zero Gravity. All right, question number two: have you ever trashed a hotel room?
I have, yes, I'm not proud of it, but, things happen. Over the years, things happen.
Fair enough. Don't worry. I won't go into detail. That's fine. You do get a point for that, though.
I've done it in a 30-year career. I've done it a couple of times. I've never been proud of it.
Hey, that's not too bad. You're absolutely fine. Don't worry. But you do get a point for that. Do you still fly economy when you do long haul? Or are you business? Are you first? Are you private jet?
I'm business.
Oh, okay, business. That's all right. That's fine. You do get a point.
I can see where you're getting at with these questions now.
You've got to wait to see who I
compare. Superstar DJs at Tomorrowland.
Well, this is it. Yeah, you've got to wait to see who I compare you to.
Now I'm actually hoping not to score very highly.
There you go. That's it. Right, you've cottoned on very quickly. Do you put any bizarre requests on your gig rider?
No.
Oh, just straight off the bat, no.
Not anymore. No, I mean, over the years, obviously, yeah. Every now and then, over the years, again, like the hotel rooms, over the 32 years of doing this, there's been some collateral damage. I have in the past put silly things on just for the hell of it. And put, when I smoked, we used to put cigarettes on, just because we couldn't be bothered to buy our own.
Makes sense.
Yeah, when I was in the house parties, we had a football on the rider.
So no way.
I mean, yeah, this time. There's times in your career when you've done a few silly things, but my rider at the moment is six cans of Red Bull, some towels and some fizzy water. Oh, and four air horns.
Okay, that's air horns for any reason, or is that just part of the act?
Oh, yeah, I mean, no, that's part of the show.
Okay.
I use air horns in the show, and we're not allowed to travel with them.
International.
So we need to source them locally. So I don't know. Does that count as a?
Do you know what? I don't think it does count as weird. I think that's a zero.
Yeah.
Happy with that. If it's okay, final two questions. Do you have any weird fans? Any kind of weird instances that's happened?
I have a lot of fans, and I have some quite interesting fans, but I would never describe them as weird.
Okay.
I have some quite interesting fans. Yeah. Who make me smile. And I have some interesting fans who make me smile, who make me hats. I people have started making me these rave hats.
Nice.
If you look on my social media, you'll see them.
Yes, yeah, I've seen a few of them. Is it the one, you've got one in your WhatsApp picture, have you? Is that one?
There's a few. I've got about five at the moment. I've got fans who make me hats. Thank you, Amy, by the way. spelled with A-I-M-E-E.
Oh, that's really sweet. Okay, well, you're absolutely right. That doesn't count as weird. I think that's quite cool. Okay, so you score zero on that. Final question. What is that? Now, obviously, being the superstar international DJ that you are, Mr. Slim, you obviously get sent a lot of free things, usually clothes and bits and bobs. But what is the strangest thing you've ever been sent for free, where you've kind of opened it up and you've thought, what am I, what?
I don't think I should, on UAE radio, I'm not sure if I could actually tell you. It was an article named after me. It was called The Fat Boy Finn. And it was an article. Are you aware of how Steely Dan got their name?
No, I'm not. Well, listen, I can tell you, Fat Boy Slim, you have actually ended our fame test.
You know, I scored. I was just building up the tension. And I scored.
And you scored 3.5 points. So I'm going to tell you what company you're in with there. You're sandwiched in between. You're sandwiched in between Mark Knight at 2.5 points.
Yeah.
And Don Diablo at 4 points.
Okay, this is like the Top Gear, like, DJ in a reasonably sized career.
Well, no, I think that's fine. I mean, you've got obviously the likes of Mr. Steve Aoki. He's in at 5 points. He's topping our fame test chart right now.
Right. Who's at the bottom? More important, I'd be more interested in who's at the bottom.
It doesn't really count. The Magician is at the bottom, but that's purely because he walked out halfway through because he was late for his gig.
which is quite rock and roll. He should have got 2 bonus points for that.
Yeah, he should have done, actually. Yeah. Gregor Salto and Max Chapman, they're all 2 points.
Oh, good old Gregor. I knew I liked him.
He's a lovely man, isn't he? He's so nice.
Yeah, he's so nice, and he makes such good music as well.
He really does.
He's one of my all-time favourite producers, yeah.
There you go. Well, listen, Fatboy Slim, thank you so much for taking the time to having a chat with us today. We are so looking forward to seeing you at the Zero Gravity Beach Festival, April the 27th. Now, it seems only right that you should choose one of your classic tracks to play us out. So what are you going to go for?
Can I go for Right Here, Right Now?
You certainly can. Would you do me the honour of introducing it?
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Fatboy Slim's Right Here, Right Now on Dance FM.